offer respect to all devotees here, ladies and gentlemen, all the children. I offer my respects to all of you. I offer my respect to the divine culture. Always meet the beautiful looking to the devotees. To the Guru Varga Srila Bhaktiloka Madhviti Maharaj. So, Kripa or mercy is for everybody necessary who came out from his original position. This is not our original position now. We are staying for some time in this human body, man or woman, very temporary. Of course, the many slokas in Srimad Bhagavatam who glorify this human life now, because this is the only possibility that you can go back home to Godhead. And that is the message of Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. He came because Krishna, he wants to bless those who are out of the spiritual world, who are roaming in this material world, to their fruitive activities, and always bruising their senses and sense objects, and forgot their original position. This is the main problem. Therefore, the Lord Himself, one name of Krishna is Lila Maya. This Maya here, all Maya, is also His Lila. There's nothing out of Him. He knows everything. So, He advented. Just last week we celebrated Sri Krishna Jamastami. All over the world, millions and millions of people, they're celebrating the birthday of Sri Krishna. Supreme Lord, who are from time to time coming here, why? To bring the feeling, the atmosphere of the spiritual world to this world here. Because 90.99% all who are here, they forgot this. Completely covered by these gunas, three gunas. They're thinking, oh my God, I'm this, what I can feel and touch and perceive. But this is 100% wrong, because he has nothing to do with it. So very few people actually understand the original position. That is called Swarup, means the original form. Every religion, they speak about the soul, they're talking about the soul, no? But who realize the soul, who live in that feeling that, yes, I'm soul, I'm not this body. I have my sambandha, my relation with the center, the Supreme Lord Krishna. This actually everywhere is a center, there's no circumference. You cannot put any fence. You say, here is a border, not existing for him, because he's unlimited, ananta, his unlimited forms. And his lila is also unlimited. And when he comes to this material world, he never comes alone. He brings all his entourage. Guru Katham in manifesting here. Radhika, Govindas, spiritual Vrindavan, bring down. But this was covered. After 5,000 years, but nobody knows anymore. Krishna, I was thinking, oh, these people, they don't understand what I'm saying in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavan Vaja, what I'm speaking, they don't understand. Again, I have to come. So we come down in the form of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Dev. And he bring all his devotees. They take birth in different places. And this was visible with the fleshly eyes when he performed his kirtans, his past, mostly performed kirtan. He not speak, give lectures like this, man. He mostly chanting Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. moving everywhere, chanting, embracing big bell and say, you chant the divine name, become pure and return back home to Godhead. This is his mission. So this mission is going on. It's now also. Because he's a Nitya Lila. Nitya Lila means always his Lila is past and is going on. But as soon as our original position, we come out from this borderline, to Dasta Shakti, become intoxicated with the gunas in this material world, we forget him. Life after life, we are roaming here. Very difficult to understand this. But by his causeless mercy, he sent his devotees now also. And everywhere there's some fit bird sounds who have enough sukriti, spiritual based bias activities from the past. They immediately they can catch up that wave, the divine wave of Krishna Chaitanya. They catch that wave and they feel, yes, this is very good, I feel very good, this is nice. So they understand spiritual topics. Dibya Gyan, divine knowledge, not spiritual matter, not spiritual subject matters, divine subject matter. It's very important to discuss this. Mahaprabhu, on the day when the devotees was there, he behaved somehow normal, speaking, doing here and this. But at night, his separation, his vibralamba about Krishna, became very severe. It's very different sattvic, all these powers appeared in him. And sometimes, one time he fell in a well inside. Śrīla Vṛndāvanadāsa Thakura telling this. And Advaita Acharya became very, oh, what do we do now? Start to lament. Mahaprabhu fell in a well in Jagannath Puri. And finally they pulled him out. And Mahaprabhu, he don't know what's going on. So Vṛndāvanadāsa Thakura is saying, if the Lord himself, if this devotee is protected by him, then what about himself? Nothing can happen to him. If protect his devotees, then what about himself? So after that incident, Mundrik Vidya Nidhi came. Always he said, oh father, father, father. He's crying, oh father, oh my father. Because he's in a feeling of Srimati Radhika. Inside is Krishna, but his feature is Radhika. So Pandarik Vidya Nidhi, Vishapanu Raja, is his father in Krishna Lila. So he Pandarik came and they discussing very happily about Krishna all night, discussing. Then next day was a festival there in Puri, where their Buddha Lord Jagannath met a cloth who coming from the rice water. They put the cloth of Lord Jagannath for the deity in rice water, soaked in rice water. So after they took out this, and they offered to the deity Lord Jagannath. When Pandarik see this, he thinking, oh, they have no standard. This is because it's impure, put in rice water, soaking, not cleaning, and give to the deity the cloth. Then Swarup Damodar also there. So they're discussing, and Pandarik, he laughing and say, oh, this devotees, yeah, they don't know, they have no standard, how they can do this, Mr. Lord? Sarup Damodar, he say, yes, they can, why not? The Lord is independent. Huh? He can do what he wants if it's his play. Huh? Then in this way, they're discussing and little blaming on the Rika. So to these servants of Jagannath. Then he, in night, when he sleep, he got one dream. So Baladev, Balaram, Jagannath, Krishna, they came and they slapped him very severely on his face. Boom, boom, very heavy, slapped him. So he, oh, oh, what have I done? What is going on? Oh my Lord, and this way, they're laughing and go away. So then he wake up in morning, oh, he look, oh, what happened to me? Like swollen cheeks like this, you know. Then Swarup Damodar came, he's laughing, hey, what's going on, Pandarik? What happened with you? What happened to you? And then Pandarik said, yes, I did some blame with devotees. night, Lord Himself, Lord Jagannath, Baladev, he came and they slapped me like this. And then they say, some people are dreaming about the Lord. But who can prove this? Is there any proof that you dream from Krishna? No proof is there. Even if you say, I have a dream about Krishna, but nobody can believe because there's no proof. But my proof, look, so swollen cheeks. Really, they came in my dream, really. It was not a dream, they really slapped me. So in this way, they passed the time in Puri, Mahaprabhu, and all devotees for 18 years, only chanting Krishna Naam and playing pastimes. Unlimited pastimes, nobody can write down. But by the blessings of the Lord, Radha Madan Mohan Govinda Dev, so the Krishna Das is writing, Vrindavan Das, they are writing. They are the Vyasa of this age of Kali Yuga now. And they're giving this nectar of Gaura Katha, about Gauranga. Those who are talking about Gauranga, listen, about Gauranga, they will enter in this divine wave of the divine couple. One day this will come. But we'll be very patient. If you chant the Hare Krishna Naam for 30 years, and not one tear comes, nothing comes, do not stop chanting. You go on chanting. Because sometimes devotees, there's maybe nothing comes. Oh, are you chanting 10 years, 20 years, 30 years? What are you doing? You waste your time. Why you not earn money? Become rich or famous? No, but then who will see the benefit the devotee get? We patiently tolerate all eventualities in this world. Just tolerate. Vaishnava means tolerate anything and everything. And patiently wait. Srila Rupa Goswami explained in Bhakti Samrita Sindhu about this, there's two birds. One bird is the Chakwara, another bird is the Chitaki. The Chitaki bird is sitting on the tree, is waiting only for rainwater.
Yeah.
If no rainwater comes, he not dig. He not go to the ground to take some water from this earth, he just wait. If one thunderstruck will come and finish his small life, he don't care because he's surrendered. Sharanagata, he's waiting. But Krishna, always he protects his devotees, always he sends his mercy. Maybe wait for some time, 30, 50 years, some life, wait. Wait. Sri Rupa Goswami gives the example of that in India. Maharaji know this bird, hear this bird, Lord, we have. So this is very famous in scripture. Chakora birds exist only from the moonlight. Like gopis, only their existence is only in the moonlight. And Chitaki bird, they wait for the raining water. Summertime, maybe long time no rain come, but rain will come sure. Not one drop, abundant water will come about him, he can quench his thirst fully. Devotee like this. Maybe long way you go, nothing big thing happened. But we have to be very patiently and wait, like this small bird. And one day everything will come. But this is the blessings of Krishna, the blessings of Rupa Goswami, and all devotees who are moving in that wave, in that line, who feel the connection with that divine thing. There's something more in life. Not about eating, sleeping, and going here and there, there's something more. And this is very, very inside, deep inside. If we can go very deep inside, there will be no karma, no krodha, no lobha, no moha, no mada, no matsajya, the worst thing, any envy. Matsajya, envy is very bad. Karma, krodha, all there are enemies there. But if you go more deep in yourself, these external things is a mind, it will not disturb you. And but you go deep only by bhajan, by singing this divine name, by the blessings of the divine name, who is personified. Nama, nami, there's no difference. Devotees still realize this. They are married with the divine name, with the divine Nam Prabhu. This is their real marriage. So if we have children, husband, wife, if we make our sambandha first to the center, because he gives the life to me, to my kid, to my all. So he is the first one. And after I make relation with all living entities, not only with my small family, with all, then this will be perfect. It will be never disturbed. If my relation is direct, oh my wife, oh only my guru, oh my friend, only my, you will feel disturbed. But if you have the relation to the center, and after the center to all, we're all interrelated, there's no problem. Wherever you go, you will find friendliness, warmness, shelter. They are searching this in this world. They're searching for this. So the Divine Lord appeared not alone. He always bring all this entourage. Divine couple, Radha Govinda, he's coming and he's everywhere actually. Also in Europe, also in America, also in Australia. They're everywhere. There's no border. Everywhere is a center. So we are thankful to our Guru Varga, who take many troubles to establish this, let's say, Prem Dharma. Sanatana Dharma, Prem Dharma means the eternally original constitutional position of ourself, our real self. They establish this. Therefore, again, I do always pray my thanks to them and pray for the mercy of all the Vaishnavas, divine couple, the holy dam, and to become a follower of all these spiritual, elevated premika bhaktas. If I get a little position there, everything will be saved. Otherwise, I will run in this universe up and down, and I lose this. Very, very divine treasure. So I don't want to speak too much to force your attention. Because so nice singing before Sunidhi and Maharaj, nice kirtan singing, the glorification of divine couple.
Yeah.
To use their all the energy, the time in the service of the divine. Because philosophy, speaking is one thing, realization is also necessary. Practical living. What I use my tongue, I speak what I speak. What my ear, what I want to hear. So everything should become transformed to the divinity. And you also become like a touchstone. Wherever you go, this fine vibration comes from your purity inside. Will radiate through the wall to just go like spreading. So therefore always please chant and remember the divine name and the Guru Devan Vaishnava. And one day you enter there and never come out. Sometimes we get a glimpse of these things, then again our mind is roaming too much outside. So we are very happy today. We have one Vaishnava, one sweet, very sweet person who are, I feel very fortunate and very happy to have a little association there and also to meet all of you. I'm very happy and thank you for listening attentively. Srila Gurudev ki jai, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj ki jai.
Good day.